The two bimolecular photochemical reactions involving the exchange of electrons are known as energy transfer, in which two electron exchanges are involved, and electron transfer, in which just one electron exchange is involved. In the energy transfer process, an initially excited state molecule, the donor, becomes the ground state molecule, and the initially ground state acceptor molecule becomes the excited state at the end of the process. The way this happens through an electron exchange mechanism is shown in the diagram here, in which the singly occupied and higher of the two levels from the donor transfers its electron into the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital on A, and one of the electrons from the highest occupied molecular orbital on A transfers to the vacant position of that lower-lying singly occupied molecular orbital on D, resulting in its ground state, and for A, being in its excited state. There's a second mechanism of energy transfer known as the dipole-dipole or Forster mechanism, and while the electron exchange operates from a collision complex, this dipole-dipole mechanism is capable of operating up to 100 angstroms away. The result is the same. Excited state D becomes ground state, and the ground state A becomes the excited state. In the case of electron transfer, just a single electron moves from the donor D to the acceptor A. The result is a pair of charges, a cation on D and an anion on A. The process can begin either from the excited state of the donor or the excited state of the acceptor. If we begin with the excited state of the donor, the process is known as photoreduction. An electron from the higher lying singly occupied molecular orbital of the excited state of D transfers to the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital of A. If we begin with the excited state of A, that process is known as photooxidation. The lower lying singly occupied molecular orbital of the excited state of A accepts an electron from the highest unoccupied molecular orbital of D. These photooxidation and reduction reactions are what's the basis of the elementary steps of the light reaction of photosynthesis, and they can be modeled by what's known as the Rehm-Weller equation, where the overall free energy change for the process depends on the donor's oxidation potential and the acceptor's reduction potential. The driving force for the reaction is the absorption of light, and you can see from this diagram, if enough energy is absorbed in either the donor or acceptor, it puts us above the energy level of the oxidized form of the donor and reduced form of the acceptor. An actual example of photoinduced electron transfer is shown at the bottom of this slide. The acceptor is this cyanonaphthalene, the donor is this trimethoxybenzene. You can work through the Rehm-Weller equation for this example and see that it's favorable to make the radical anion that's shown here. You should be able to draw this electron configuration and the radical cation of the donor that's seen here.